Hello! So let's get all Avengers to get a bit weird and strange. Hello and welcome to another Matt and Sci-Fi Bill. And don't worry, it's not video overload this week. Right, I went to a comic mart yesterday, bought a ton load of DVDs, which I'm really happy about. I got Supergirl's latest season, Flash, Legends of Tomorrow, Arrow season 7. I just got loads of it, and it's going to take me 2 months to watch it, or even longer. So, but when I was there, I was going to order it off Amazon. I came across something I've been after, but I'm sort of half and half on this. The Avengers, the Cybernauts Trilogy. I thought there'd be a lot more with this. I was expecting a lot more, but I have enjoyed watching it today. So you only get one disc, and you get the three major episodes of the Cybernauts, Dr. Armstrong in the first one. And then, which is not a bad episode, it's all nicely transferred onto Blu-ray, which is rather cool, which I really loved. And then we got the second one. The first episode's alright, it introduces Cybernauts, it lags a bit in some places, but it's got the Avengers feel, Steed and Mrs. Peel. Doing their thing, and that's what's fascinating about it. Michael Goff, who's the butler of Batman, he's playing Dr. Armstrong, the scientific genius who wants to create a cyber police state and the whole world run by cybernauts. You know, he's completely mad, but this is what you love. He's in his wheelchair pressing his buttons, and I don't know, some of the technology do quite fine, sort of funny, you know, but I loved it. It had the Avengers wackiness, and it was quite a basic story. He's going around knocking people off because he wants certain things from about transistor technology and all this, and they figure it out and end up turning his, well, they don't turn his own cybernauts, but Steed manipulates one cybernaut to attack another, and he gets killed as Professor Armstrong in the episode. And that's the end of Automations or something, United his company, and it's great. And then we jump to episode 2, which is the real treat. The story, you would have expected more of a world domination aspect to it in the second episode, the Cybernauts Trilogy. The second episode is brilliant. I'll tell you why. Peter Cushing, being a suave, seductive type businessman that's got a thing for Mrs. Peel, is very classy and very, very, he's very just gentlemanly, but he's this like evil person who wants revenge on Steed and Mrs. Peel. And it's great. I mean, really, you know, you think to yourself, would you really go through all this? Well, he's kidnapping scientists, and he puts them in these like rooms in his mansion to create a device to kill them two, to make them stuff. I thought, well, why would you do that when you've got a load of cybernauts at your command and just kill them, you know? But we won't go there. This is where you start questioning it. But you've got Fulton McKay, you know, McKay and Fraggle Rock as this really cold scientist who's just greedy. The other two scientists he kidnaps, like, they're a bit nervous, you know. And they're sending Cybernaut out on these missions. And he's Lauren Steed and Mrs. Peeling. And when these two scientists, he kills one scientist, they create a device. You turn human beings into cybernauts. It's honestly, it's just really funny, you know. And there's a big battle, and I don't want to, you got to watch it, but it's simple, it's British class all the way through. It's sheer genius of pure Britishness, and I absolutely loved it. But I thought the story could have, I thought I would have expected more than just a revenge story. But again, you've got Peter Cushing, you know. So, a sci-fi worship to Peter Cushing. And then we move on to episode 3, which I, you see, the new Avengers. I love the original Avengers series. I'm such a big fan, but when I was growing up, the new Avengers were mine. You know, Purdy, Gambit and Steed. I have reviewed the new Avengers on YouTube. It's on one of my videos. I will try and put it under here, the link. But I just adore the new Avengers. My Avengers. It's like James Bond, we all have our favourite one, or Doctor Who, we've all got our favourite theme within it, and mine's definitely the new Avengers. The stories are just bonkers, right? Felix Kane, the baddie, is a double agent. Birthday party starting at Steve's. Guy turns, has got information, dies at Steve's front room. They're in a car park, chase this dude round in Jag, Range Rover and Perda, and he goes crashing into a petrol tanker, blows up, that's it. In kicks the Fiend, brilliant. But the transfer to Blu-ray has been amazing. I thought it was a really good transfer. So we get into the story. This insane villain who wears masks for pleasure and masks for pain and masks for... He's got his beaming face. And he becomes a... He kidnaps this scientist. Oh no, they get Goth, who used to work for Armstrong and the other Cybernaut people. He's come out of prison. They get him, but he's just an engineer. He's, well, a mechanic. All he can do is just be told what to do. So they kill him. They kidnap this scientific genius who's... like a cyberneticist specialist. And they kidnap him, and this goth who's in wheelchair, weird face, got this creepy assistant called Malad, who just like, yes sir, would you like me to do this now? You know, and this guy, this goth guy, is totally insane. And they turn him into a cybernaut, and it's hilarious what happens after that. And he spent all this time just, he's got pictures of Purdy and Steed and Gambit all over his... He's got a lair, and I love it when they have a lair with a bar in it, you know, and all this, and a creepy servant, and an army of cybernauts in there. It's just brilliant. But really, it's like, you could question a lot of, like, this guy's vengeance. He gets turned into a super cybernaut, and it is... How they defeat him is hilarious. And it just... brings that magic of the Avengers forward for me, you know, the insanity of it, you know, the classic stories. So that's you know, the last of the Cybernauts. I don't want to, you got to, if you've watched it, then fair enough, but if you haven't seen it, you've really got to get into this sort of, back then, British humour really out there, and the writing for TV was, I think the writing back then for a lot of these wacky TVs, then it was totally insane, just outdo a lot of stuff today. Everything were new and fresh, and creativity got a lot of freedom, and they pulled off a lot of stuff back then. Just genius episodes of insane stuff. But onto the DVD, onto the Blu-ray, sorry. So you get a very nice cover. I do like the cover to this. I would, you know, and it says on the back, a nine little word, beginning with C. That's one of Steve's lines in second episode, and the third one. Cybernauts, the most efficient of killers, brainchild of electronic genius Clement Armstrong, Michael Goff, and defeated, so it seemed at the time, by John Steed and Appeal. But the Cybernauts would be backed, resurrected by the suave but diabolical Paul Beresford, Peter Cushing, and finally by double agent Felix Kane to exact revenge on Steed and his new companions, Purdy and Gambit. Now, for the first time, the three parts of the Avengers trilogy are brought together in brand new restoration from the original negatives. This set features vintage experience. I've had a look at that. This is summit down points I'm going to go into. Vintage expert, an option to play all three episodes with ad breaks and contemporary commercials. Now, a brand new 32-page booklet from the noted television historian Andrew Pixley. That's marvellous. I've read it. I've actually read quite a bit of it. That made it worth it. The vintage setting, I ain't got time for. I'm not interested in seeing adverts from how many years ago. Honestly, I'm not. I was a bit annoyed with that. So that's inside, as I've showed you. I love the cover work. I like that. I think that would have been better as the cover for me. Say we stayed up here and the Avengers. I don't know. I think that's how it should have worked. I think they missed an opportunity with this set. I have enjoyed it, guys. I'm not knocking. But I thought for what this cost, it wasn't cheap. It was more or less around about 20 quid. And I would have liked to have paid a bit cheaper than that. But the booklet is spectacular. And there's some interesting stuff in here. Especially with the Cybernauts. DC Comics, a couple of years ago, did a story. Emma Peel and Mr. Steed and Mrs. Peel teamed up with 1960s Batman, right? And they ended up with Clement Armstrong's intelligence were in a computer and they were controlling his daughter or his, they were controlling Cybernauts, and they teamed up with some supervillains, which I just think, that's TV Batman, you know, from the 60s, which I think is absolutely insane. I never read The Man from U.N.C.L.E., Batman and Robin team up. I keep meaning to look into that. I'm going to have to. But this is what happened on... in the comics, and there's been quite a few spin-off stories, a novel furthering the Cybernauts and that, but I would have liked to have seen this book into a 30-minute documentary on this set, and possibly an interview with, you know, Joanna Lumley or any sort of any actors or writers or anybody, you know, who's about today. It would have been a nice touch, I think. And that sort of disappointed me. This book is very nice. You get a lot in it. But I made some great pictures in there. And I love the look of the Cybernauts. I just think that they are so cool. But there should have been some extras, I think, for what this cost. I really do. And I'll probably get panned for saying that. But, you know, sat watching the three episodes today was really enjoyable, and I like the transfer, and I'd like to see New Avengers out on Blu-ray. I really would. I've got the other sets on Blu-ray of the, you know, the Steed and Mrs. Peel, so I'm quite happy with them, and there's some great extras on them, but it would have been nice to see a bit more with this. But again, I'm a big fan of the network studios that are releasing this stuff. Well done, you guys. You've really done them. You've done everybody proud. But yeah, great. And you know, I could have that as a canvas picture of that. You know, I think it's so cool. I just think there's just the mist. It's out of 100, I'd say it's about 92%. The mist, the summit, not quite right. We could have got more. But I do like the cover. But I do prefer, I like the thing with the three Cybernauts, which I think would have worked, but that's me. But I'm very happy to get this. That's my review of the Network Cybernauts Trilogy Blu-ray review. So guys, I'll be on Sunday at 7 o'clock, you know that. I will be doing science fiction. It'll be an open show, so let me know what your thoughts are on stuff through the week. I'm going to be doing another Could Have Been a Classic later this week. So that should be, I'm sort of planning all that out now. So that's it. So have a great week, guys. And I will see you on my next video. And I do recommend this. Give it a look. And I'll speak to you soon. All right, guys. Have a great Monday.